Hi and welcome to the channel. Today I'm going to teach you how to convert your text into a table, and I'm going to teach you a variety of different ways to do that because not everyone wants to achieve just one result. So I've started off with a default document just with a list of animals, and I'm going to show you the various things that happen when you convert text to table and vice versa. So I've got this list here, and if I just go to the home tab, I'm going to go along to this icon here, show and hide formatting marks. So if I click on this, all the blue marks show you the return keys that you've got in, you've got any tab keys. So let's say, for example, after this title, I put in a tab key, you're going to get this little arrow here. That will affect how Word will transfer your text into a table. So I'm just going to show you that the only thing that I have after any of these words is simply a return key. So you can identify any problems or issues you might have by clicking on this formatting mark icon. So I'm just going to switch that off. I'm going to select everything by using Command or Control A. Then I'm going to go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, go down to the bottom to convert text to table. And then within this menu, I'm just going to show you what happens if I just click on the default settings. I've got one column and it's all on automatic, and it's going to separate by paragraph. So if I just click, this is what Word will do to your list. It's just simply put it inside a column and plenty of rows. Now, if you don't want that, I'm going to go back one step, Command or Control Z to go back. I've made sure I've highlighted all my text again. Go to Insert, go to Table, click on the drop down, and go again down to Convert Text to Table. Now this time, I want all of my text on the left in a column, but then I also want a column to the right. Now you can have two or three columns, it's completely up to you, but I'm just going to have one column on the right. So this time, I'm going to click on this icon first. I won't go up to the columns, because if I do that, let me just click on two, if I use this up arrow here, then click on commas, do you see it goes back to one? So I've clicked on commas first, then I've used the up arrow to go to two columns, and then I'm going to click OK. Now you can see I've got those two columns with the text on the left. Now again, if I go back, if I go to Insert, Table, and the Convert icon, this time I'm going to convert it to four columns, but I'm going to leave it on paragraph and then see what happens. You'll see that Word has just made the list and just followed the list all the way along and listed all of your text in rows. Now, that's probably not what you're aiming for. If it is, that's how you do it. But it's unlikely that's what you're aiming for. So let's go back. Now, what many people want to do is to line up their text in the various columns and rows and then convert it to a table. But you may just have a list. This is all copied from AI. So I've simply got a list, and let's say I want to put all of these in a nice neat table. So what I need to do is start to put some tab marks. So if I go next to Tiger, I'm going to switch this icon in here so you can see exactly what I'm doing. I'm going to zoom in. So I go to Tiger, press the delete key. So it's right next to the previous word. Then I'm going to press my tab key. Then I'm going to do the same with elephant and press the tab key. Now I'm going to go for four columns. So there I have my four columns, and I'm going to do the same with the rest of it. So I'm just going to tab them across. Okay, so very often you'll just have a list like this and you simply just want to put it into the table. So again, we'll just select this and the title as well. We'll go to Insert, Table, click on the drop down, convert table to text. This has got one column. We're going to go for four columns, and then we can go from paragraph to tabs and then click OK. And as you can see, let's just go back to the home tab and take those formatting marks off. We've put this all beautifully into a table. Now, if you want this just to fit the space that you had originally, so let's just go back. You see this is only taking up, let's say, two thirds of the page and not this space here. You can go back to Insert, go back to the Convert Text to Table. You can click this icon here, Auto Fit to Contents. Let's increase that to four columns again. go to tabs and then click OK. And you can see it will only take up the space of your original design. You can see they're not quite equal. And the reason is that is because you've asked Word to basically squeeze it in to make the table fit that space. The way in which you can make sure they're all even is you're going to have to move this line out to the edge here if you want to make your table bigger to accommodate that. Because then you can go up to layout and click on this icon here. But you see there isn't quite enough room still for this one. So go back, make the table a little bit wider, try it again. And there you go, they're now all of an equal width. So the other thing you can do with this table once you have finished putting the text in is you can merge the cells at the top. So let's say this title wanted to go into the middle here. Select all of these cells across this top row, go to layout and select merge cells. And then you want to center it, so select it, go to this icon here and center it. If you want to get rid of this row here, just click inside the row, select the row, right click, go down to delete cells, and then it says shift cells left and just click OK. If you want to release everything from this table, simply select it all, go to the home tab, select copy, and then I'm going to move my cursor down just about to here. Go to paste, click on the drop down and select keep text only, and then everything's out of that table. Now, if you want to customize your table further, I'll leave a link in the description below for another video that will go into more detail about that. So I hope that's helped you today. If it has, please like and subscribe and have a great day.